Hello everybody, Brent Oak Guy here, and welcome back to the Chunk World. So today we're going to do the tutorial for the Breeding Trading Center. Alright, so first of all, this is going to be a lengthy tutorial a little bit. And second of all, there's a slight direction. It's not an issue, it's just a change of redstone that you're going to have to do in order for it to work in two other directions. So if you're facing towards your left of your map, or the down portion of your map, so facing this way, your villagers would be facing that way. Alright, so this, you could build it the way I'm going to show you how to build it. If you're going to face it to your right, or to the north, up, you're going to have to add in a torch. You're going to need 8 additional torches. That's it. And 8 additional pieces of redstone. Same as redstone, it's just the torches. That's right. So you're going to need a 19 by 23 long area. That's all the brick area. The white area would be like a wall, say if you're putting a wall around it, okay? So the 19 wide and 23 long is where everything is going to be maintained in, alright? So we'll get rid of this and we'll start off here. So starting off on your corner here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, and 3. Put that there, and then every other, get rid of it like this, and you're gonna have 8 slots, okay? And you're gonna come 2 to the end, so that's how you know you're gonna be done. Alright, so now behind these, you're gonna wanna go up 2 like so. Do this for all of them. Oops. Again. Ah, man. See, almost I caught myself that time. There we go. And then now, coming off this back one right here, you build it out like this. And that way it comes directly over top of this right here. Okay? Then, the counting this block here is 1, 2, 3, 4. Go down 2. And over 6, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then you're gonna want to go up and then straight over until you're right in the middle of these two last cells. And I think it's up like that, if I'm not mistaken. Alright, yes, I got my glowstone up here. No, come back. Alright. So above here, you're going to go up 3, okay, and then you're going to go 8 like this, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, alright, this goes back 1, just like that. Alright, now we can add in some power rails and some normal rails, and this, I'll trade in for that. So we'll put in a lever there, and another lever there, and then we'll just power rail the whole thing right up to that point there. And then this point here on, we can just do normal rails. And the part that's kind of like direction sensitive is the tracks itself. How the tracks are going to behave, and when I get to the redstone aspect of all this, you'll understand. So just continue building it like this no matter what direction you're facing it in, okay? There's nothing that's going to change other than the redstone itself. So Where are we here? Alright, so we're up here building the cell. This is where our villager is going to come out of. So we're going to build it up like this. All the way around. And then you got that there. So coming over one, two, and on the third, we're just going to build it out like this, 8 blocks. That's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And now we're going to put up a wall around it. It's got to be too high. This way the baby villager does not escape. We don't want him going anywhere other than when we're telling him to go. Yeah, actually that one's okay. That's fine right like that. So this part I can get rid of that. And that I can keep. Alright, so like I said, the wall's got to be too high. This part's going to be 3. Try to get this done as fast as I can, so that way everybody is happy. Alright, so we're going to need a water bucket. Gonna put our first water bucket right here, and you're going to see it's going to stop right at the end. And then you're going to grab some glowstone, first of all. And you're going to go 1, 2, and then 1, 2. So you're going to have like this. Alright, go up 2 more, and get rid of these right here, okay? So that way you're 2 up, but you're 2 away from everything. And then we'll grab our signs. Place some signs on this. There you go. And then we can add our water in the back here. And you're going to see it's going to stop right at the edge here, and this one is going to be all independent, and your villager is going to go down that way. Now, it's really important to use a transparent block here, just because of the fact that when your minecart comes along, your villager is either picked up way back here or here, so at any of this point in time, he could take suffocation damage if you don't want him to get any damage. Alright, so now we got our area where our villagers are gonna be in. And we're gonna grab some glass here. Alright, and we're gonna go 1, 2 up and over. And then we're just gonna build a nice little cage area for them. And I suggest using glass here too, is because they glitch out in the walls and they push each other around, and then they're going to get stuck in the wall in the corner here, and they're going to get suffocation damage. So it's good to use glass. I stress that. Alright. So now, we are at this point here. So, 1, 2 is here even with them. So 1, that's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then go over 2 like this, and 1 here, okay? Then go get rid of this, and it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, alright? So this little pillar right here we can get rid of, we don't need it. That was just to count out where our cell up top is going to be. Now we're going to do like a 6x5, alright? So there's 2... 3, 4, and 5. And then down here we're gonna come over 1, and we're gonna go right up to the end. So that way we're leaving 1 block of space right here. We'll come and we'll cage all this in. That way no water can escape. That's perfect. And that spot we're going to leave blank, and we can come over here like this, and we can add our, in our wall. That's just going to be out like this. That's going to be here, and that's that's going to be here like this. We got another wall over here. And another wall over here. Perfect. Then we can grab some doors. And we're going to need 6 doors here. And on the reverse side of that, we're going to need 6 dispensers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And get rid of this here, because I'm going to need some water buckets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Perfect. And we're going to put a water bucket in each one of these. I had one in my hand. I must have skipped one. Just verify. Alright, we're good, we're good. So here again, we're going to take out these 4 blocks, okay? And we're going to put some glowstone in. This will help keep your area nice and lit up from mobs. And then on the top of this here, oops, we're going to lay some wool. You can put whatever you want in here, but I'm just showing this what's going to be wiring, okay? We'll remove that right here. And we're going to put a sign here. Oh, I screwed up here. Sorry, people. It goes like this, alright? Because we're going to need a sign here. Here, 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 and here. Then we'll come back out here. Just put one block there for now. Grab some more sticky pistons. We'll put some stickies here, all alongside there. And I'm gonna grab some glass. I say use glass because in this way, well, if anything happens, well, he won't glitch out into these blocks at all. Alright. Alright, so that's that. Now, we can add a little roof to this. To this right here. That way he's not going to want to get out anywhere. And there we go. That's going to prevent him from getting out anywhere. Now, we're going to have to put a water bucket here, and then that goes all nice into there, and it's going to flow down here. Now, I suggest using glass for this next part, just because mobs won't spawn in here, and your guy's going to be 100% safe. Come out 3 like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then going to be underneath here. That, alright, seems higher up than normal. Doesn't it? Oh, I think I know why. It's because normally I put up a 2 more wall there, which isn't really necessary, but would probably be better. He might not take as much fall damage either. Yeah, that's true. Oh well, we'll put a sign and maybe a water drop for him. Maybe that might help his descent, or we could put like maybe a vine in here. Something like that there that'll help slow his descent down. That way he's not going to take fall damage. Because I think he still will take fall damage if he's going to be in there. There we go. This can come right up equal with that. Same with this here. Off of here like this. This has got to be too high. That's going to be too high. And my water bucket is here. So we put a water bucket here and it's going to flow all the way right to the end. Now we're going to need a sign in this bottom corner and right there. And then we'll finish off the glass wall here. Perfecto. Alright, so right here, not that one, but the second one above it. You're going to put a sticky piston with a glass block on top of it. And I stress the glass block once again. Then come over here like this. You can use other glass, other blocks other than glass, but I think it'd be better to use glass. That way he doesn't glitch out anywhere and kill himself just because they're that smart, right? Alright, so now we're going to go back in here. And we're going to take a water bucket and we're going to place it here. A sign above it. A water bucket. A sign above it. A water bucket. A sign above it. And a water bucket. We're getting pretty close to the end here. And then we should be able to take another water bucket and just place it here like that. And now he'll come all the way up to the top. Now we'll take some glass. If you put it like this, he won't have a tendency of wanting to jump out. And as soon as he gets to this point, he's going to fall down. And he won't be able to get up here where our redstone is going to be. So that's your villager section down here and up here completed. Alright. And we'll put in our villagers in the end and we'll get all that good stuff going. So now we're going to do some redstone. We got to get this stuff up and going. So we'll put detector rails on these things here. Okay. And this is going to tell our system whether there's a minecart or not. So coming from underneath. Now this is the part, no matter where you place it, it's going to change. So if you're placing it from like south and west, you'll be fine. If you're north or east, you're going to have to do this instead. If you're north and east, you're going to have to put a torch on all of these, okay? And then you're going to have to put a block here on every other one, like so. Up one, up one, up one. And like that, alright, so repeaters and redstone would be good. Now we'll go and put a red repeater on each one of these with a piece of dust. Oops. There you go. And that's what you're going to have to do if you're facing it north or east. Now, if you're just doing it south and west, you're just going to do it a little bit differently. Actually, these I can get rid of because I'm going to need that block there. You're just going to do it like this. There you go. And we're just going to add some redstone here. So that was the difference in redstone that you're going to have to do depending on what direction you're facing that. Alright, so now continuing the southwest way, we're going to add a torch to the top of all of these, and then we're going to pair up these ones here like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Am I really missing one? How is that possible? Huh, I miscounted. Really? I'm having a hard time believing that, but whatever. I guess I miscounted. Sorry, people. Nothing really changes anyways. It's all good. Kind of funny that I only realized that now, but whatever. Doesn't really change anything, so and there we go. That's that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Wow. I can't believe I did that. Oh, whatever. Same thing. It's all good. So now, we're gonna need some blocks up on this top one right here. Oh, like this. Then we're gonna put redstone. We're gonna finish our AND gate system here, and that's what we're doing. We're making a bunch of AND gates connect together. Alright, so now you're gonna go like this, every second one. And we're gonna go up one. Connect those two. Go up one. And connect those two. Repeater. Repeater and repeater and repeater. Dust. Or torch, torch. And dust in the middle. Torch, torch. Dust in the middle. We'll come down here in front. We'll put a torch and a torch. And we'll go here like this. Like that. Up one. Over three. And we'll put a repeater. Repeater. Dust, torch, torch, and torch. And then coming over here, like this, lining yourself up. And I guess that would be it, eh? So right underneath. Yeah, that's right underneath. And then we're gonna build a tower going up, like this, alright? All of these, every second one, and I think that's how we're gonna end it, like that. So I'll put a repeater here, bunch of dust, torch, 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 and we'll keep going up until we get to the top. Alright, so that's gonna be our very top one. So here, you're going to need a torch. I'll put a block. Block. Skip one. And a block. You're going to need that sticky piston back. I'm going to put a sticky piston here. That there. Repeater on three in the front. This one on nothing. And then a torch here. Now, I'm going to come off of this torch here like this, off the side, up one like that, like this, up one here like that, and like this. Now, we need to put a repeater on four, this one like that, a piece of dust here, a repeater on three there, and a piece of dust right there. Just confirming that I did everything right, and you're gonna need another piece of dust right there. Then coming under here, you're gonna put a sticky piston with a block, and then I guess you could come out like this, and we could put our dust going down right across here like that, and then that's gonna activate our water. Now let's go test all this out to make sure it's gonna work. So we'll put a track or a minecart on there, and you're gonna see that the torch here turns off. We'll put another one, that torch turns off, and this one turns on now. So now it's sending a signal to this one saying, okay, section one is good. Then when section two is going to be good, this one's going to turn off, and that's going to turn on, turning this one off, and so forth. So, let's go and put one on every one of these, and now we go up, watch the water come out. It's going to wash the villager down into here, and he's going to go where he needs to go. And we'll go up here, and we'll finish off this tunnel in a second, okay? And then if you remove the cart, all that goes out, and it all flows away, all nice and dandy. Alright, so that's that part of the system. We'll just get rid of these now. Now let's go up here and finish off this right here. So now, He's gonna need a way to land. So let's grab some glass. So he's gonna come down here like this. Top of that. No. Should we? Alright. Let's try this. If I put a sign here. A water source block there. That's okay. Shouldn't it? I don't think that destroyed much. Yes, it did. More than I thought. Alright, that's no big deal. It's kind of dumb. Power rail. And then torch. Oh no, that torch is good. Oh nice. I like how that flew. Or flowed. So let's try this out and see if I'll drop a villager in there. And we'll see how he reacts to that. Because all the way down, up and around. And then in he goes. Most excellent, most excellent. Welcome home, Mr. Villager. Alright, so now let's hook up these pistons on the side, and then we'll add two villagers after that, and we'll be good. So here, we're going to take the blocks, and we're going to go just on the outside like that. This one's going to be run off of a power, so it's going to be like this. We can put a block here to save a piece of redstone, and same right here. So what we'll do is we'll put our repeater here and here, and then we'll just add some dust here. Going like this. All those pistons are going to be pushed out, and he's going to be nice and safe in there. So now, let's go do that bottom piston. This one's got to be on and off power. I'll put a block here. Come off this off power, which is that one, probably the closest, right? Yes, yes it is. Alright, we'll go like that. Yeah, sure, whatever. Go like this, and I'm gonna need probably a repeater at one point in time. Very possible, but this one you're gonna need a repeater going into that block, otherwise you're gonna see it's not gonna extend right. Let's count that out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. No, you make it. That's perfectly awesomeness. Alright, so now we're gonna finish the minecart thing here. This thing right here. And then this pretty much will complete the project, and then we'll put the last two villagers in. So your minecart is going to have to come out, I guess, one more. A few little gaps here. I've only built this a few times, so I'm actually kind of surprised I've gotten this far without screwing up big time. Alright, so we're going to come up to, or roughly about here. Okay, we don't want to go up any higher than what we need to. And then we'll come down here. Oops. And right here. And then this one can go like that. No. We'll go up here on the sides. Build this up. Oh man, seriously? Like that. Be even there, and then we'll just do this one last side. Perfect. We'll put that there. We'll cover this up that way the villager doesn't want to go anywhere other than where we want him to. Alright, we'll put two like this. We'll come down here and stay away from the corner because you don't want anybody taking damage going through a corner. And then you can end it like that. And then we'll get to the other part afterwards. So you can cover this up like that if you like. And then that way it kind of lights up a little bit down here for you. So first of all, we're going to need in here is a... I'm done with that. I can put there. So on this third block... Not the third block. That third block, we're going to put a trapdoor, okay? And then from there, we're going to go like this, over two, down one like that. Actually, I'm going to come down one more. And then we're going to go over. And then from here, we're going to go like that. We can get rid of this block right there. Now, from here, we have to put that like this, and like that. Alright, now this is where you're going to put your hook and tripwire. Really? What happened to my hook? I must have gotten rid of it. Alright, so now we're going to put a hook, that tripwire in the middle. Now here, you're going to have to put half slabs. There. Right here and here. You can't put full blocks because then your tripwire won't work right. Alright. And then we'll trade you back. Put a full block here and here. And we'll go dust. Repeater. Dust. Repeater. Dust, and a repeater. And we'll just trip you back up. Now, I'm going to grab our sticky piston, and a block, put a sticky piston here, and that there like that. Now, whenever a villager comes out here, and he's going to trip this, and it's going to send out a signal for a minecart. We're almost done, people. We're almost done. Now we just gotta build up a way for our minecarts to get back to the top. Add some levers to the front where our cells are gonna be, and then we're done. So let's get rid of this here. Like I told you, it was gonna be a lengthy tutorial. It's not a very small thing to build. There's a lot of little things to this, so we'll just get power rails, that. Won't need that. And we'll get a few of these. Perfect. Alright, so we'll get rid of this sign. We'll put a block. Some power rails. We'll go out, what did I do here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alright. Then you're gonna go a block up. And we're gonna go two blocks up. And we're gonna go out two, up one. And from this block here, you're gonna go up one. And up one again, and like this, and up one, up another one, and out two, up one, out two and up, one, up one, two and up. Two and up. We're getting there, we're getting there. Two and up. Oops. Wrong one. And we're almost there. And two and up like that. And then we'll just go up here like this. Finish it off like that. We got power rails here. Put two normal rails, and then the rest here is all power rails. I recommend power rails because it's just faster. If you need a good glitch to get more power rails, I suggest you looking at Overlooked ENT's channel. He's got a really nice one out there that works just fine. And then we go back right behind here. On every one of these blocks, we put a lever, turn it on. And almost there. There we go. And then we just gotta put one more. We'll put it right underneath here, since we can. Alright, now for mob's sake, you're probably gonna wanna light this up with something. So, yeah, I'm just gonna use a glowstone. I'm just gonna put a glowstone lamp on here. That's just in case any mobs decide to spawn in here and ruin your party. So that's that. Now, then you would just case all that in and you would be good. And now let's go and add a bunch of minecarts to the system. And this you can do at any rate. There's no specific rate that you have to not do this in. And you see they all go up nice and right in there. So we're almost full. Alright, that should do it. Yeah, that's good enough. Now, we're going to have to do something about holding the villagers in. And this is like the last part that we're going to do before we toss in a villager in there. Alright, so you're going to want to come... Alright, we'll do this part first. This will be easier to find the rest of the way. I can get rid of that. Alright, so up above each of these blocks, or above these torches, you'll put a block. This will be the easiest way to do this. And that way you know what you're doing is right. And we'll get rid of that, put you in its place, so you torch all of these, like so. And then we're going to put a block on top of these. This is what's going to change your track direction when it comes time, when it receives the signal. And that'll show you afterwards. Now, you got this, I need redstone. I'll put redstone on top of all of these. And for one, do like this, and like that. I'm going to need my half slabs. I'm going to half slab that, and I'm going to cheat, and I'm going to go like this all the way across. Like this. And, oops, every second one I'm going to get rid of. There we go. Then I'm going to go up like this, and I'm going to put another half slab here, and I'm going to cheat again. Probably the easiest way of doing that. And every second one, we'll get rid of it. You got a nice little pattern there. And here we're gonna put a full block like this. And then we'll go, where's my sticky? There we go. Sticky piston pointing down on all of these like that. And then we can run some dust off of this. And that's how you connect all of that. And perfect. So if I add a minecart to that, it pushes it down. Take the minecart off, it pushes it back. Oh. Okay, oops, sorry, my bad. My bad, that was funny actually. Come out one more. I was off by one. Alright, so, off by one people. Very sorry. There we go. Oh, that's pretty funny. There we go, just like that. Hey, mistakes happen, right? That's the whole point of these tutorials, to show you what kind of mistakes you can do. Alright, there we go. That's just perfect now. Now, to show you that it changes the track, like I was saying, you have it going pointing into the cell. If you put a mine right there, it changes it so that way it goes straight. So that's the mechanics behind that. This, we can put a full block here. In front of that, we're going to put a sticky piston here like this. And get rid of this. I'm going to put some glass here like this. And then we'll build a nice little glass casing for these guys here. That way nobody gets out and everybody stays in there, because when you reload your map, villagers don't stay in their carts anymore. So that's a little bit of a bummer, but no big deal. We'll work around that. There we go, just like that. Now your villagers will be nice and safe in there, and they will have nowhere to go. So now all you have to do is put a block in front of these things right here. Add a torch to all of these, or a torch, lever, sorry, and I suggest activating these as well. That way the BBs don't escape at all, because they can't escape through that half block, alright? So that is your system in a nutshell. Everything's done and fine and dandy. Now there's only one last little option that I didn't show in my showcase, and that was to add like an indicator light showing that everybody was full, that there was somebody in the system. So what you can do for that is you can bring it over like this. Alright. And you can just put some repeaters here like this, and then we can grab some lamps, and we can put a lamp here like this. So, or you could lead them going outside your building, it all depends on what you feel like doing. So, once again, demonstration, I'll turn that on. Put that there, the light turns on signifying that somebody's there. And then you can take that off and the light goes out, and that's that. So now let's put in our two last villagers, and then that will be that. The whole system is done. So what I'll do is I'll just sit around here and AFK a little bit there, and I'll watch them breed. And fill up a few cells, and I'll come back with you and show you. Don't look at that, they're already hard at work. And the system works just fine. So I'll see you back in just a little bit when I got one or two of them little guys in there. Alright, so we got one little guy in here, and I believe we got another one right out in here. And I'm just going to go knock him down just to get him in there a little bit faster. And that way you can see the system in action. Come on, little guy.
Come on. Come on. Come on.
There we go. It's in a minecart and gets sent away. Now you can add some walls here like this, just to cover it, just to make sure that the little guy doesn't decide to jump out. And then that's all I suggest you do now. Now that you got two lights on, you have two villagers in here waiting to breed, or waiting to grow up, and you got the other two villagers in there gonna breed again. So that's it, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Sorry it was so long, but there was a lot of things to cover in here in order to make this system work perfectly for everybody. So I hope you all enjoyed this. Peace, everybody. Take care.